Hello friends, YugabyteDB is a distributed database designed to function across multiple database servers, availability zones and regions. But as developers, we like to run things locally, especially in the beginning. In this video, I'll show you how to use the YugabyteD tool to set up and scale the database clusters right on your laptop, from single node to multi-region configurations. Let's go! The YugabyteD tool is included in the database release bundles. So, start by downloading the latest release from the YugabyteDB website. Next, Given will be setting up multi-node clusters, make a dedicated directory on your laptop for the database configuration and data. Now, everything is ready to start the first database cluster. Go to the bin directory of the release package and use the YugabyteD start command to bootstrap the first database node. The node will run on the 127.0.0.1 loopback address and store its data and configuration in the home Yugabyte node 1 directory of your laptop. Once the node has started, you can check the cluster status and view metrics with the YugabyteDB user interface. Now, let's connect to the cluster from the command line and issue some requests to the database. Simply use the YugabyteD connect ysql command and specify the directory of the database node. Once connected, you'll notice there are no any user tables yet. A quick tip, use the ybservice function to view the current cluster topology. If you require a sample dataset for your initial experiments, the YugabyteD tool has got you covered. Simply use the YugabyteD demo connect command to create the schema and load data from the Northwind dataset. This sample database contains the sales data for a fictitious company called Northwind Traders, which imports and exports specialty foods from around the world. Alright, it's time to scale our database from a single node to a three-node configuration. For macOS users, there is an additional step. You'll need to set up 127.0.0.2 and 127.0.0.3 as loopback addresses explicitly. Next, use the YugabyteD start command to add the second node to the cluster. This node will run on the 127.0.0.2 address and connect to the first node. Furthermore, the second node will store its data and configuration in a separate subdirectory called node 2. To start the third node, just change the subdirectory name to node 3, update the node's advertised address to 127.0.0.3 and run the start command one more time. Finally, go back to the YugabyteDB UI to see that you've got a multi-node cluster running on your personal laptop. As you remember, we have the Northwind database in the cluster, and this sample dataset is already distributed across your three-node instance to utilize the storage and CPU resources available on each node. That was straightforward, wasn't it? But what if you are developing a global application and need to pin user data to a specific cloud location? Let's explore how to use the YugabyteD tool to create a geo-partitioned cluster with custom cloud regions right on your laptop. First, we should shut down the current cluster. Use the YugabyteD stop and destroy it commands. Start by destroying the first node, and then proceed with the second, and the third one. Alright, now let's set up a multi-region geo-partition cluster. Our first node will be located in the United States East Coast. Therefore, we are setting the cloud location parameter to AWS US East 4 Zone A and adjusting the fault tolerance to the region level. Then we start the first node. The second node will operate within the European Union. To set it up, we'll assign it a unique IP address and ensure it connects to the first node. It will store its data and configurations in a distinct subdirectory. And, most importantly, we are setting its cloud location to AWS Europe West 3 Zone B. Next, let's initiate the third node in Australia by setting its cloud location to AWS Australia Southeast 1 Zone B. Once all the cluster nodes have started, it's time to modify the data placement policy. Utilize the YugabyteD configure data placement command to set the fault tolerance setting to the region level. Now, if you jump back to the YugabyteDB UI, you'll see that you have a multi-region cluster running on your personal laptop. Moreover, the region names can be aligned with those planned for your production environment. How about we test this cluster to ensure it's ready for development of our global application? First, we'll create tablespaces for each chosen cloud region. US East 4, Europe West 3, and Australia South East 1. Next, we'll create a sample table for customer profile data. This table will be segmented into three partitions, with each partition holding customer data based on their geographical location. Moving forward, let's use the YugabyteD tool to connect to the cluster and then create the discussed tablespaces and partitions. Once the database objects are ready, you can double-check that the profile table is, in fact, split into three partitions. Now, imagine our application adds a customer who lives in Berlin. We can simulate this scenario by executing a straightforward insert statement. If you examine the execution plan for the query retrieving this record back, you'll observe that YugabyteDB fetched the data from the partition located in the European Union. You can also directly query this partition table to confirm that the record is indeed stored in Europe. For further verification, you can examine the partitions belonging to the United States and Australia to ensure they don't store a copy of the European Union residence data. Easy, right? Job done! That's how straightforward it is to use the YugabyteDB tool for starting and working with multi-node clusters of different configurations on your personal laptop. Enjoy building scalable apps with YugabyteDB. Bye-bye now!